Ashwagandha, what is it and can it help with anxiety? Well, in this video, we're going to be looking at the science behind ashwagandha, answering four key questions. What is it? How does it work? Is it effective? And is it safe? So that by the end of this video, you'll know whether or not you should be using ashwagandha to treat anxiety. But first, g'day legends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name's Jesse Crow and I'm the traveling scientist. Currently living here in Jindabyne, Australia. And on this channel, we explore science-based techniques and ideas to help you live a smarter, happier, and healthier life. Now, I've recently made a video all about anxiety and general anxiety disorder. You can check that out just up here. And I also have a free e-booklet all about living with anxiety. So if you have a struggle with anxiety, you can download that at any time. It's totally free. It's just in the description down below. So what is ashwagandha? Ashwagandha, also known as Withania somnifera or winter cherry, how freaking cute is that? I love that name. It's an evergreen shrub that grows mainly in India and the Middle East, but is also found in other parts of Asia and Africa. And the name comes from the Hindu word Ashva, meaning horse, and Gandha, meaning smell, because apparently it has a strong horsey odor. Anyway, the name somnifera is actually Latin for sleep inducing, which is pretty appropriate, because ashwagandha is very well known for helping you to relax and calm down. So how does ashwagandha actually work? Ashwagandha is known as an adaptogen, which means it's a natural substance that helps the body adapt to stress. It's not exactly clear how ashwagandha works, but after doing some research, everything seems to point to the fact that ashwagandha just improves your overall well-being by regulating certain hormone levels, things like adrenaline, noradrenaline, dopamine, and the improved balance of hormone release is believed to reduce stress levels, promote relaxation, improve your sleep, and treat your anxiety. And that all sounds well and good, but what does the research into ashwagandha actually say? Well, a recent study in 2019 looked at 60 stressed out subjects and split them into three groups. One group took 600 milligrams of ashwagandha every single day, one group took 250 milligrams of ashwagandha every single day, and one group took 250 milligrams of a starch placebo every single day. And after 8 weeks, it was proven that the subjects who took ashwagandha every single day had much lower stress levels than those who were taking the placebo. And the higher ashwagandha dosage was associated with greater levels of stress reduction. Furthermore, the study also looked at sleep quality and showed that the subjects that took ashwagandha actually had improved sleep quality compared to those that were taking a placebo. Now, there are many, many other similar studies that have similar results, and I don't want to bore you with all those details and statistics. Suffice it to say that ashwagandha does indeed appear to be effective at reducing stress, promoting relaxation, and treating anxiety, which is awesome. But what about the side effects of this so-called winter cherry? Look, ashwagandha has been used for centuries in traditional Indian medicine, so it should be relatively safe, but there are a few side effects that I'll tell you about. First is sedation, which makes sense. Ashwagandha is a natural relaxant, so it is gonna make you feel tired. Ashwagandha can also cause headaches, but look, anything can cause a headache. Take an aspirin, don't complain. Ashwagandha can also sometimes cause diarrhea or nausea, so, you know, look out for those. And remember that we don't really know exactly how ashwagandha works. I'm sorry, I tried to figure it out, but everything just says it improves well-being. But we believe that it does this by regulating certain hormone levels. So if you have any hormone-sensitive conditions, or if you're taking any medication, maybe talk to your doctor before you go self-prescribing this random ancient Indian root extract that's gonna help you with your mental health. Just a thought. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, legends. Let me know what you think about ashwagandha in the comment section down below. I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.